Greetings, fellow human. I'm Rose from happyandauthentic.com, and you're watching my series on how to be happy. This week's happiness strategy is to nurture an attitude of abundance. There are two kinds of people in the world, those who have a scarcity mindset and those with a mentality of abundance. The scarcity mindset advocates that happiness is mainly based on material things, but material things are in limited supply. They eventually run out, so people who base their lives on scarcity feel like they need to make sure they get as much as they can before someone else does. On the other hand, the abundance mentality is based on the idea that success and happiness are not based on material things, but on the concepts that these things represent, like safety, fulfillment, love, and energy, all of which are limitless. Of course, the scarcity model is a bit more widespread than the abundance one these days, and that's for two reasons. One is evolution, and the other is consumerism. So firstly, when we were evolving as a species, lack of resources was a very real danger, and evolutionarily speaking, those who focused on it stayed alive and passed on their genes. But life today isn't quite as brutal as it was in the Stone Age, at least not in Western countries. Back then, if someone else got a larger than average portion of food, that really did mean there would be less for you. But it's not like that anymore. Resources are way more abundant now, and so it's about time we upgraded our mindset to fit our reality. But like I said, evolution isn't the only thing perpetuating the scarcity model. Western society was mostly founded on this mentality of lack. The news tells us there's a shortage of jobs, marketers tell us products are only available for a limited time, we're told good food is hard to find and that the economy could crash at any moment. This constant feeling of fear and scarcity makes us frantically buy things we don't even need in order to keep the economy running. We compete with each other to hold on to jobs we don't even like. The unfortunate side effect is that it's creating a world full of frightened, anxious people stuck in a desperate loop of lack. We take things too seriously. When we fail, it feels like the end of the world. And that creates a self-fulfilling prophecy because this negativity makes us see obstacles that wouldn't otherwise be a problem, thus limiting our very chances of success and making us believe the lies are true. People who focus on scarcity act as though everything in life is a limited commodity. Like there's only one pie out there, and if someone else takes a massive piece for themselves, it'll leave much less for you. To those who live like this, life is a zero-sum game. Like the only way for you to win is for everyone else to lose. And thinking in this way makes it really hard to share things like recognition, money, time, power, and love. It makes you feel like you need to hoard what you have and compete with others for every other resource. This quickly leads to feelings of resentment, envy, and anxiety. Pretty much any negative emotion you can think of, because people are terrified of losing what they already have or of missing out on something they could possibly have in the future. In their head, it's as though there's only one nice car, house, and yard in the world. So if John next door scores them before you do, that's it, game over. You might as well go live in the sewers. But it's not even remotely like that. So this fear is unfounded. And it seeps into other areas of life as well, to the point where you can become so scared of making a mistake, you won't innovate or work well with others in a team environment. You might dedicate your life to collecting as much money as you can at any cost, or you could become stingy with affection because you think you only have so much to give. Nothing good comes of thinking in this way. All a scarcity model does is harm everyone involved. But the opposite, a model based on abundance, has nothing but good things to offer. It's the paradigm that there's plenty of everything out there for everyone. In fact, there's enough to spare. People who live their lives based on this model share everything openly with others. They're comfortable being generous with their time, their money, affection, and energy because they know they will never run out of the things that truly matter. This creates an environment of cooperation, creativity, and kindness, which is what we want. And I know a lot of people are scared of adopting this kind of mindset because they think it'll make them reckless and irresponsible. But just because you believe that money will always come and go doesn't mean you automatically have to spend like there's no tomorrow. An abundance mentality won't make you waste your savings or take stupid risks. It's not about deluding yourself that you have more than you do, so it won't lead you to live beyond your means. It's about knowing in your heart that there will always be opportunities to make more money if you're willing to look. That's why people who have this mentality frequently donate to charity, because they know they can always make more money, and it's okay if they give some away. They're not fearful, and that's the main thing that distinguishes the abundance model from the scarcity model. But it's not just about money. Yes, people who see life as abundant often end up building enormous financial success for themselves, but they also achieve success in other important areas as well. First and foremost, this mindset improves performance by alleviating stress and anxiety. It reduces jealousy and envy, which results in better personal and professional relationships. Of course, if you suffer from jealousy or envy, an abundance mentality isn't the only thing that can help. Click here to learn more easy ways to get over these emotions. An abundance mentality helps people regain control of their life by improving their confidence and self-esteem. It's the kind of thinking that allows people to quit their jobs and start a business, because the fear of failure stops being an issue when you realize it won't be the end of the world if you make a mistake. You end up trying harder and more often, which can lead to more opportunities to succeed. Also, there's less attachment to the outcome of any situation, so you don't react emotionally. Instead, you can control your emotions and respond rationally, which, if you watch this video, you'll know is a major advantage. You'll be less scared of other people getting what they want, so you'll be more generous and helpful towards them, which will obviously make you more likable and will increase your chances of receiving help in return. And finally, not only does it give you more perspective by allowing you to focus on the long-term effects of any decision you make, but it can also help you feel more clear, alert, creative, and adaptive, all of which are tremendous advantages in the modern world. If any of this sounds intriguing to you, but you're unsure how to transition from a scarcity mentality to a more abundant one, I've written an article called 15 Ways to Transition from a Scarcity Mindset to an Abundance Mentality, and you can find it on my website, happyandauthentic.com. If you'd like more help, I offer breakthrough sessions on Skype. You can sign up using the link in the description. If you're new to my happiness series, click the subscribe button and you'll get a new video every Sunday. I also have a newsletter that you can sign up for if you'd like me to email you the links to each weekly video and article to make it easier for you. The link to that is also down below. Anyway, I'll see you when I see you. Until then, remember, happiness doesn't require energy. It requires strategy.